I like to test myself. I like to test myself by joking about horrible things and nothing but. One of my favorite ways to test myself, I like to make jokes about tragedies the day that they happen. The day they happen. I don't believe in too soon. I'm on a tight schedule. And I'm good at it. I'm good at it. Like the day of. The day of the Aurora, Colorado Batman movie theater shooting. The day it happened. I went online, I went on Twitter, and I tweeted, other than that, how was the movie? Right? Right, nailed it. Nailed it. And the reason I get away with that, the reason I get away with stuff like that is I'm just the guy who does it. People are used to it from me. It'd be weird if I didn't make a joke the day of a tragedy. Which is why I was very surprised when I got in a lot of trouble the day of the Boston Marathon. Now, I don't follow the news regularly, but I know the second a tragedy happens because I get 25 text messages saying, don't do it. And whenever I see that, it makes me sad. It makes me sad because I know something horrible has happened. People will say, Anthony, what's funny about Aurora? What's funny about the Boston Marathon? What's funny about your grandmother's funeral? Nothing. Nothing is funny about those things. That's where I come in. So I see these texts and I'm like, oh no, what happened? But I also think I've got a job to do. So I go online and I start reading about it. I don't want to watch the footage, but I'll read about what happened. And I think, how can I make someone laugh today? And then I think, I got it. I go back on Twitter, and I tweet, guys, today there are just some lines that should not be crossed. Especially the finish line. And again, I think nailed it, USA, USA. But then my phone starts to ring, and it's my boss. Or should I say, my former boss. And they say, Anthony, this is unacceptable. You are not just a comedian today. You're also the host of your own TV show with your name in the title on our network. You take this joke down right now or you're fired. And I say, go fuck yourselves. And I meant it. I didn't get into comedy for the money or the fame. I know that sounds wrong, because I'm dripping with both. I only got into this business so that no one could tell me what to do. And they said, sure. And they said, well, Anthony, you don't understand. You don't understand at all. If you don't take this joke down right now, if you don't delete this joke right now, not only are you fired, but the entire cast and crew of your television show, about 100 people, they're also out of a job. And I'm ashamed to tell you this. I'm embarrassed to admit it. But in that moment, I folded, and I deleted the joke. Because I'm happy to fight for what I believe in. I'm happy to take the consequences for what I've done. But what I could not do, what I cannot do, is walk up to my cameraman and say, hey, buddy, no work for you on Monday. I had this sweet tweet. Couldn't do it. But as soon as I hit delete, I got mad, and I regretted it. I would fire every single one of those fucking assholes now, I'll tell you that right now. And I got mad for betraying myself and everything I believe in. I'm just as mad today as I was then. Just as mad. So mad, I had to have a meeting with the network where they called me in for a little lecture. And they're like, Anthony, we're family. Why are you so upset? Can't you see we did you a favor? Don't you worry about your career? Let me ask you, San Francisco, do I seem like I worry about my career? No. Do you know why people who win the lottery always end up going bankrupt? Because if they worried about their money, they wouldn't have played the lottery in the first fucking place. I do not worry about my career. They said, well, Anthony, the problem is that when you make a joke on Twitter the day of a tragedy, it seems like you're making fun of the victims, and that's wrong. But that's not what I'm doing. Because you see, the day of a tragedy, victims are not on Twitter. Am I wrong? Tell me I'm wrong. The day of a tragedy, victims have got victim shit to do. No one has ever been putting on a tourniquet asking, hey, are we trending? No. This is who I'm making fun of when I make a joke on Twitter the day of a tragedy. The people who see something horrible happen in the world and they run to the internet and they run to their social media, their Facebook, their Twitter, whatever they got, and they all write down the exact same thing. My thoughts and prayers. My thoughts and prayers with the people in Aurora. My thoughts and prayers with the families in Boston. Do you know what that's worth? Fucking nothing. Fucking less than nothing. Less than nothing. You are not giving any of your time, your money, or even your compassion. All you are doing is saying, don't forget about me today. Don't forget about me. Lots of crazy distractions in the news right now, but don't forget how sad I am. Those people are worthless and they deserve to be made fun of. They're like a wedding photographer who only takes selfies. You understand?